Hello, this is Professor Jyoti Iyer, working as Associate Professor in Government Engineering College, Morasa. Today, we'll be discussing on the topic of single-phase AC circuits. Already, we have seen how the RMS and average value are found for alternating current and voltage. We'll start with AC circuits when applied to resistance, inductance, and capacitance alone. We'll now start with the PowerPoint presentation. First, we are going to consider the AC circuits containing only resistance. So, we are going to consider a resistor connected to an alternating voltage source E equal to Em sin omega t. We'll now transfer to the teletop. AC circuits containing only resistance. We are going to consider a resistor R connected to an alternating voltage supply given by V equal to Vm sin omega t. That is, an alternating voltage supply V is connected to a resistor R. This will cause a flow of current in the circuit. And this current will be given by Ohm's law. Ohm's law states V is equal to IR. Therefore, the current I in the circuit will be equal to V by R. That is equal to Vm upon R sin omega t. Therefore, we can write I is equal to Vm by R sin omega t. The current I will be maximum when sine of omega t is equal to 1 or when omega t is equal to 90. So, substituting the value, putting omega t is equal to 90, we get sine of omega t is equal to 1. Therefore, the current I becomes maximum, that is equal to Vm by R. Therefore, we can write current I is equal to Vm by R sin omega t, but Vm by R is equal to Im. So, I becomes Im sin omega t. Now, we've seen that the resistor was connected to an alternating voltage source V equal to Vm sin omega t, and we have derived that the current in the circuit I is equal to Im sin of omega t. So, for a resistor, we have V is equal to Vm sin omega t and current I is equal to Im sin omega t. If we plot both these waveforms, V is equal to Vm sin omega t, so it follows the sinusoidal rule. 0, pi, this is 2 pi. When omega t is 0, pi or 2 pi, the value of V is 0. When omega t is pi by 2, V will be having its peak value. When omega t is pi by 2, when omega t is 3 pi by 2, we will be having an amplitude of minus Vm. We will be having an amplitude of minus Vm. Similarly, if we plot I is equal to Im sin omega t on the same curve, you can see that when omega t is 0, pi or 2 pi, the current waveform is also 0. The current waveform also has got a 0 value. So, we can show it this way. This is the waveform for the current I is equal to Im sin omega t. And this is the waveform for the voltage V is equal to Vm sin of omega t. As you can see, the current value is also equal to 0 at omega t equal to 0, pi and 2 pi. for omega t equal to pi by 2, the current waveform has got a peak value Im, and for omega t equal to 3 pi by 2, it has got a peak value equal to minus Im. So from both these waveforms, it can be seen that for a resistor, both the voltage as well as the current waveforms, they attain their zero values as well as their peak values at the same time. The voltage as well as current waveforms are attaining their zero values at 0 pi, 2 pi simultaneously, and they are attaining their peak values at pi by 2, 3 pi by 2 in the given waveform simultaneously. And so we can say that for a resistor, the voltage and current are in phase. Since the voltage and current waveforms, they attain their zero and peak values simultaneously, they are said to be in phase with each other. We'll now again go back to the teletop. So, for a resistor, V and I are said to be in phase with each other. For a resistor, V and I are said to be in phase with each other. If we draw the phasor diagram, the phasor diagram will be shown as this is the x-axis, y-axis. If the voltage is represented along the x-axis, if the voltage V is represented along the x-axis, the current I will also be along the x-axis. It means that voltage and current are in phase. For a resistor, there is no phase difference between voltage and current. Voltage and current are in phase. They attain their zero as well as peak values at the same time. We will now derive the power equation . What is the expression for the power for a resistor? The instantaneous value of the power P is given by the product of the instantaneous values of the voltage and current in a resistor. The voltage is given by Vm sin omega t, we have just seen. The current is given by Im sin of omega t. So this becomes Vm into Im sin square omega t. Sin square omega t is nothing but 1 minus cos 2 omega t divided by 2. So in place of sin square omega t, we put the power P is Vm Im sin square omega t is 1 minus cos 2 omega t divided by 2. So this becomes Vm Im by 2 minus Vm Im by 2 into cos of 2 times omega t. So we can say that the power P, it actually consists of two parts. This is a fixed part, a constant part, and this is a fluctuating part or a changing part. As you can see, the term over here is cos of 2 omega t. It means that this particular term, it rotates at twice the supply frequency. Our supply frequency was V is equal to Vm sin omega t. It was only omega t, but here it is 2 times omega t. So it means that this, the fluctuating part, is rotating at twice the supply frequency. We can see that by plotting the fluctuating part. The fluctuating part, I'll represent that as, say, Fp is equal to Vm Im by 2 into cos of 2 omega t. I'm going to plot this for different values of omega t. When omega t is equal to 0, the fluctuating part will be equal to cos 0, so that becomes Vm Im by 2. When omega t is equal to pi, This becomes cos of 2 pi, which is again 1, so the fluctuating part is Vm Im by 2. When omega t is 2 pi, again this becomes 2 of 2 pi, that is cos 4 pi, which is once again 1, so the fluctuating part is Vm Im by 2. If we take omega t is equal to pi, if omega t is taken equal to pi, equal to pi by 2, already we have taken that equal to pi. If omega t is taken equal to pi by 2, this becomes 2 times pi by 2. So 2 times pi by 2 is cos of pi, and cos pi is minus 1. So the fluctuating part becomes minus Vm Im by 2. If omega t is taken equal to 3 pi by 2, in that case, this becomes 2 times 3 pi by 2, that is cos of 3 pi, which is once again minus 1. So the fluctuating part becomes minus Vm Im by 2. Next, we are going to take, this is our fluctuating part, Vm Im by 2 cos of 2 times omega t. Next, we are going to take omega t is equal to pi by 4. When omega t is taken equal to pi by 4, this becomes the fluctuating part. It becomes cos of 2 times pi by 4, that is cos pi by 2. And cos pi by 2 is 0, so the fluctuating part becomes 0. When omega t is 3 pi by 4, again this becomes cos of 2 times 3 pi by 4, that is cos of 3 pi, cos of 3 pi by 2, and therefore the cos of 3 pi by 2 is once again 0, so the fluctuating part becomes equal to 0. So now, using all these, that is when omega t is 0, pi or 2 pi, the fluctuating part is Vm Im by 2. When omega t is pi by 2, 3 pi by 2, its value is minus Vm Im by 2. And when omega t is equal to pi by 4 or 3 pi by 4, we are getting its value equal to 0. We will now plot the fluctuating part with respect to omega t. This is the fluctuating part. When omega t is 0, pi, 2 pi, we have found its value to be equal to Vm Im by 2. So this is Vm Im by 2, Vm Im by 2, and this is also Vm Im by 2. When omega t is equal to pi by 2 or 3 pi by 2, its value is minus Vm Im by 2. So when omega t is pi by 2 or 3 pi by 2, we are getting its value equal to minus Vm Im by 2. This is Vm Im by 2. This is minus Vm Im by 2. Next, when omega t is pi by 4, when omega t is 3 pi by 4, similarly here at these two points also, we'll get the fluctuating part equal to 0. Now, if we plot, so it is 0 over here, it is 0 over here. Here, these are the points that we have attained. So now, if we plot the graph, we will get such a waveform. As you can see, from 0 to 2 pi, the voltage waveform was completing only one cycle. But this fluctuating part is actually completing two cycles. That is, it is rotating at twice the supply frequency. Now, if you can see, this is a symmetrical waveform. So the average value of this fluctuating part over an entire cycle will be zero. That is, the average value of the fluctuating part over one complete cycle is equal to zero. And therefore, we can say that the total power which is consumed by a resistor is equal to only the fixed part. What was the fixed part? The fixed part was equal to Vm Im by 2. So this is equal to Vm into Im by 2. But this can be written as Vm by root 2 into Im by root 2. Now, you all remember Vm by root 2 is nothing but the RMS value of the voltage. Im by root 2 is the RMS value of the current. So, we can say that the power consumed by a pure resistor is nothing but the product of the RMS values of the voltage and current. It is nothing but the product of the RMS values of the voltage and current. Also, if we want to plot the power waveform, what was the expression for the power? We had derived the expression for the power as Vm Im by 2 minus Vm Im by 2 cos of 2 omega t. So, power is nothing but Vm Im by 2 minus Vm Im by 2 cos of 2 omega t. We just plotted the waveform of this fluctuating part to show that its average value over a complete cycle is 0, and therefore the total power that is consumed by a pure resistor is only equal to Vm Im by 2, which is nothing but the product of the RMS values. If we are plotting this waveform, let us see what type of waveform will we get. Again, we are going to assume different values of omega t. First, we put omega t is equal to 0. When omega t is put equal to 0, this becomes cos 0, and cos 0 is 1. So, it is Vm Im by 2 minus Vm Im by 2. So, the value of the power that we get is 0. Next, if we put omega t equal to pi or omega t equal to 2 pi, this becomes cos of 2 pi. And when omega t is 2 pi, this becomes cos of 4 pi. Again, these values are 1. So, that is minus Vm Im by 2. So, the power equation becomes Vm Im by 2 minus Vm Im by 2. The power expression is equal to 0 when omega t is 0, pi or 2 pi. Next, we will see when omega t is equal to pi by 2. When omega t is equal to pi by 2, this expression becomes 2 times pi by 2. 2 times pi by 2 means cos of pi, and cos of pi is minus 1. So, that minus and this minus will become plus. So, ultimately we will get P is equal to Vm Im by 2 plus Vm Im by 2, that is equal to Vm into Im. Similarly, if we put omega t is equal to 3 pi by 2, again here we will get 2 times 3 pi by 2, which is cos of 3 pi, and cos of 3 pi is equal to minus 1. That minus 1 and this minus 1 will become plus 1, and this becomes Vm Im by 2 plus Vm Im by 2. The power becomes Vm into Im. So, now if we are plotting this power waveform, the power waveform, this is 0, pi, this is 2 pi. As you can see, when omega t is 0, pi or 2 pi, the values are 0. When omega t is pi by 2, when omega t is 3 pi by 2, we get its values equal to Vm Im. So, let the values be equal to Vm Im. Let this constant part be Vm into Im. So, when omega t is pi by 2, and when omega t is 3 pi by 2, we get the values equal to Vm Im. So, if we plot the graph, we get it to be, here again you can put different values of omega t and get other instantaneous values also. You can put omega t equal to pi by 4. Here also you can put some other value, and we can get instantaneous values so as to plot this graph. So, the graph that we get is something of this sort. So, it can be seen that for a purely resistive circuit, the power is always positive. This is the power waveform. The power waveform is always positive, and the total power that is consumed is given by the product of the RMS values of the voltage and current. So that is what? The total power consumed by a purely resistive circuit is given by the product of the RMS values of the voltage and current, and this power is nothing but the total heat which is dissipated in the resistor. We will now consider a pure inductor to be connected across an alternating voltage supply. We have considered a pure inductor to be connected across an alternating voltage supply. Now, what is a pure inductor? We'll go back to the slide, PowerPoint presentation. Yeah. A pure inductor is an ideal case. It is nothing but a coil having zero resistance. A coil having zero resistance is not possible. The coil may have turns which are very thick. The turns may be very thick, resulting in a very high cross-sectional area. But even if the cross-sectional area is very high, it will result in very low resistance. The resistance will not be zero. So, a pure inductor means a coil having zero resistance. And it is not possible to have a coil having zero resistance. But here we are going to consider the ideal case that the coil has got zero resistance. We'll go back to the teletop. So, a pure inductor has been connected to an alternating voltage supply given by V is equal to Vm sin omega t. The resulting current will produce a magnetic field in the coil, which will also be alternating in nature. Now, since the flux linking with the coil is changing over here, according to Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, there will be an EMF induced in the inductor coil. This EMF induced is called the self-induced EMF. The self-induced EMF, say it is given by E dash, and E dash is given by L di by dt, where L is the inductance of the coil, the inductance offered by the coil. The inductance offered will be in Henry, and di by dt is the rate of change of current taking place through the coil. So the self-induced EMF in the inductor is given by E dash is equal to L di by dt. Its direction is given by Lenz's law, which states that the self-induced EMF, it acts in such a direction so as to oppose the cause of its production, and therefore E dash becomes minus L di by dt. Now, the applied voltage at each and every instant opposes, it is equal to and it opposes the self-induced EMF in the inductor. The applied voltage at each and every instant is equal to and it opposes the self-induced voltage in the inductor. So we can write V is equal to minus of E dash, and that is equal to minus, what is E dash? Minus L di by dt. So minus of minus L di by dt. So it becomes equal to L di by dt. But what is V? V is nothing but Vm sin omega t. So we can write Vm sin omega t is equal to L di by dt, or di will be equal to Vm by L sin of omega t dt. If we take the integration on both the sides, this becomes I is equal to the integral of sin omega t is minus cos omega t by omega. So this becomes Vm upon omega L. The integral of sin is minus cos omega t upon omega. Omega has been taken outside. So this is minus cos omega t. This becomes minus Vm by omega L. Cos omega t is nothing but sine of pi by 2 minus omega t. That is equal to Vm by omega L. We take this minus sign inside. So, it becomes sine of omega t minus pi by 2. Here, the term omega L is called, or rather it is designated as XL, and it is called the inductive reactance of the coil. It is called the inductive reactance of the coil. Therefore, the inductive reactance XL is omega L. But what is omega? It is 2 pi f radian per second into L. XL is equal to omega L, that is 2 pi f L, these many ohms. It is called the inductive reactance of the circuit. So, in place of omega L here, we substitute the value of XL. What is this? I is Vm by omega L sine of omega t minus pi by 2. In place of omega L, we now write XL so that we get I is equal to Vm by XL sine of omega t minus pi by 2. This is the expression for the current through an inductor. Here, I will be maximum when sine of omega t minus pi by 2 is equal to 1. And the maximum value will be equal to, when sine of omega t minus pi by 2 is 1, the maximum value will be equal to Vm by XL. And this we are denoting as Im, maximum value of the current. Therefore, we can write current I is equal to Vm by XL. But what is Vm by XL? It is maximum value of current Im into sine of omega t minus pi by 2. Now, we started with the expression, the voltage that is applied. The voltage applied to the inductor is Vm sine omega t. And we have derived that the current through the inductor is Im sine of omega t minus pi by 2. That is, voltage is Vm sine of omega t. And the current through the inductor is Im sine of omega t minus pi by 2. From both these expressions, it can be concluded that in case of an inductor, the current lags the voltage by an angle of pi by 2. Remember, for the resistor, we derived that if V is Vm sin omega t, I is Im sin omega t, that is V and I both are in phase. But in case of the inductor, if V is Vm sin omega t, the current is lagging it by an angle of pi by 2. So, if we plot the voltage and current waveforms, the voltage waveform first, which is taken as the reference, 0, this is pi, this is 2 pi, this is the voltage waveform given by Vm sine of omega t, this is the amplitude, this is minus Vm. Now, the current waveform is lagging the voltage waveform by an angle of pi by 2. It means that this is pi by 2, this is 3 pi by 2. It means that the current waveform will attain its zero as well as peak value 90 degrees after the voltage waveform is attaining its zero or peak value. For example, the voltage waveform is attaining its zero value over here. The current waveform will attain its zero value after 90 degrees, means over here. So, here the current waveform will, or the current waveform will be something of this sort. As you can see, I is 0 90 degrees after V is 0. The voltage is attaining its peak over here, but at this instant, the current is 0. When the voltage becomes 0, the current is attaining its peak. And so on. So, this is the expression for the current. I is equal to Im sine of omega t minus pi by 2. So, for an inductor, the voltage and current have got a phase difference of pi by 2. The current lags the voltage by an angle of pi by 2. These were the waveforms of voltage and current. We will now see the phasor diagram. how the phasor diagram can be drawn. This is the x-axis, y-axis. If the voltage is shown along the reference E, or we can say V, it is shown along the reference. For a resistor, we found that the current is in phase with the voltage. But now for an inductor, the current lags the voltage by an angle of 90 degrees. This is the voltage phasor which has been shown. The current is lagging the voltage phasor by an angle of 90 degrees. So this is the phasor diagram shown for an inductor. Next, we will derive the expression for power of an inductor. Again, the instantaneous value of the power is given by the product of the instantaneous values of the voltage and current. The instantaneous value of the voltage is given by Vm sin omega t. The instantaneous value of the current is given by Im sin of omega t minus pi by 2. We just derived this. Im sin of omega t minus pi by 2. We have just derived this expression that for an inductor, the current lags the voltage by an angle of pi by 2. So P is nothing but the product of the instantaneous values of the voltage and the current, Vm sin omega t into Im sin of omega t minus pi by 2. So that is Vm sin omega t into sin of omega t minus pi by 2. This is nothing but minus Im into cos of omega t. Sin of pi by 2 minus omega t is cos omega t. We take the minus sign common. So it becomes minus Im cos of omega t. So this becomes Vm into Im into sin omega t cos omega t. I am going to multiply and divide this expression by 2. I am going to make this 2 sin omega t cos omega t and again divide it by 2 so that the final result remains the same as we had previously. So this becomes Vm Im by 2 into 2 sin omega t cos omega t. 2 sin omega t cos omega t is nothing but sin of 2 omega t. So the expression for the power for a pure inductor is Vm Im by 2 into sine of 2 omega t. Now, we have to find what is the average value of power consumed in the case of an inductor. We can plot this waveform. At the same time, we can find its average value using the average value method. How is that done? P is equal to Vm Im by 2 into sine of 2 times omega t. We got P to be equal to Vm sin omega t into minus Im cos of omega t. We have multiplied the numerator and denominator both by 2. Minus sign needs to be taken out over here. So this becomes minus Vm Im by 2 sine of 2 omega t minus Vm Im by 2 sine of 2 omega t. We are going to find the average value of this power waveform. P is minus Vm Im by 2 into sine of 2 omega t. How do we find its average value? The average value can be found over a full cycle. So the average value is equal to 1 upon pi from 0 to pi of minus Vm Im by 2 into sine of 2 times omega t. We know that the average value over a complete cycle is 0. So the average value is generally found only over a half cycle. So this becomes 1 by pi, the integral from 0 to pi of minus Vm Im sin of 2 omega t. So that becomes minus Vm Im by 2 times pi. The integral of sin 2 omega t is minus cos 2 omega t divided by 2. So this becomes Vm Im by 4 pi into, this is cos of 2 omega t, and the limits are from 0 to pi. The limits of integration have to be put from 0 to pi. So this is equal to Vm Im by 4 times pi. This becomes cos of 2 pi, in place of omega t we put pi, minus cos of 2 into 0, that is 0. Cos of 2 pi is 1, cos 0 is also 1. So this becomes 1 minus 1, which is 0. And therefore, the average value of the power which is consumed by a pure inductor is 0. The average value of the power that is consumed by a pure inductor is 0. We could also have done this by plotting the curve of P is equal to minus Vm Im by 2 into sine of 2 omega t. If we plot this curve, when omega t is equal to 0, the value of the power is 0 because sine 0 is 0. When omega t is pi, sine 2 pi is again 0. When omega t is 2 pi, again its value will be equal to 0. When omega t is equal to pi by 2, this becomes sine of 2 times pi by 2, that is sine pi. Sine pi is again 0, so p is equal to 0. When omega t is 3 pi by 2, this becomes sine of 2 times 3 pi by 2, that is sine 3 pi, which is again equal to 0. When omega t is equal to pi by 4, we get this to be equal to sine of 2 times pi by 4. Sine of 2 times pi by 4, that is sine pi by 2, and sine pi by 2 is equal to 1. So p becomes minus Vm Im by 2. When omega t is equal to 3 pi by 4, this becomes sine of 2 times 3 pi by 4, that is sine of 3 pi by 2. Sine of 3 pi by 2 is minus 1. That minus and this minus will become plus 1. So the power becomes plus Vm Im by 2. So now if we are plotting the power waveform versus omega t, we know that when omega t is 0 pi 2 pi, power is 0. So 0 pi 2 pi, the values are 0. When omega t is pi by 2, 3 pi by 2, again its value is 0. So pi by 2 value is 0, 3 pi by 2, again its value is 0. When omega t is pi by 4, between 0 and pi by 2, that is pi by 4, it has got a value of minus Vm Im by 2. So it will have a value of minus Vm Im by 2. This value when omega t is pi by 4. And when omega t is 3 pi by 4, that is over here between pi by 2 and pi, its value is plus Vm I by 2. So it may be somewhere over here plus Vm Im by 2. So we get this point. So again over here we'll get this point. Again over here we'll get this point. The curve that we get is this is the curve that we get. That is, as you can see, this is the curve for the average power that is consumed by a pure inductor. You can see that a voltage and current during one cycle from 0 to 2 pi, they complete only one cycle. But the power waveform is completing two cycles. This is one cycle. This is the second cycle. Because the power waveform is varying at twice the supply frequency. It is 2 omega. Omega is 2 pi f. So this is 2 times omega. So that is at twice the supply frequency. And as you can see, the average value over a complete cycle, this is one cycle, this is another cycle, but the average value is equal to 0 because we are getting a symmetrical waveform. Therefore, the average value of the power consumed by a pure inductor is equal to 0. For a resistor, we saw that the average value of the power consumed is the product of V and I. But for a pure inductor, the current lags the voltage by 90 degrees and the average value of the power consumed by a pure inductor is zero. Next, we will see AC circuits containing only capacitance. So, once again, we are going to consider a pure capacitor which is connected across an alternating supply, E is equal to Em sin omega t. Now, a pure capacitor, once again, is an ideal case. Pure capacitor means it won't have any losses. But here, it is an ideal case which is not possible, but we are going to consider a pure capacitor to be connected across the alternating voltage supply. We are considering a pure capacitor C connected to an alternating voltage supply of V is equal to Vm sin omega t. This will cause the capacitor to be charged first in one direction and then in the other direction. Let Q be the charge on the capacitor plates at any instant. Let V be the potential across the capacitor plates at any instant. Q is the charge on the capacitor plates. Let V be the potential across the capacitor plates at any instant. Therefore, we can write Q is equal to C into V. That is equal to C into the potential applied is Vm sin omega t, so that becomes C into Vm sin omega t. Now, the current in the circuit I is given by the rate of change of charge. I is given by dq by dt. The current I is given by dq by dt, the rate of change of charge. But q is equal to, we have derived Q to be equal to C Vm sin of omega t. So, this becomes dQ is C Vm sin of omega t. Therefore, the current expression becomes d by dt of C Vm sin omega t. And that is equal to C and Vm are constant, so C Vm we are taking out d by dt of sin omega t. The derivative of sin omega t is omega cos omega t. So this becomes omega we are taking out C Vm into cos of omega t. This is written as Vm upon 1 upon omega C into cos omega t is written as sine of pi by 2 plus omega t. This becomes, this term 1 upon omega c is called the capacitive reactance xc. The term 1 upon omega c is called the capacitive reactance xc. Therefore, Xc becomes 1 upon omega c, but omega is 2 pi f. Therefore, Xc becomes 1 upon 2 pi fc. Therefore, the current expression, which was Vm by 1 upon omega c sine of pi by 2 plus omega t, becomes I is equal to Vm by, it was 1 upon omega c sine of pi by 2 plus omega t. This becomes Vm by xc, because 1 upon omega c we have named as capacitive reactance xc, into, I write this as sine of omega t plus pi by 2. Instead of pi by 2 plus omega t, I take omega t first, pi omega t plus pi by 2. This is the expression for the current through the capacitor. Now here the current I will be maximum when sine of omega t plus pi by 2 is equal to 1. When sine of omega t plus pi by 2 is equal to 1, the current I will be maximum. What is this maximum value of the current? Is equal to Vm by Xc. Because maximum current will occur when sine of omega t plus pi by 2 is equal to 1. So, I max is Vm by Xc. So, we can write this particular expression as I is equal to Vm by Xc. But what is Vm by Xc? It is maximum value of current. I am sine of omega t plus pi by 2. So, we started with capacitor connected across an alternating voltage supply of Vm sin omega t, and we have derived the current through the capacitor to be Im sin of omega t plus pi by 2. I'll write this down. The voltage and current expressions will be written down together. V is Vm sin of omega t and I is equal to Im sin of omega t plus pi by 2. So, if we see both these expressions, it can be seen that the current waveform is leading the voltage waveform by an angle of pi by 2. For an inductor, we derive that the current waveform is Im sin of omega t minus pi by 2. But here it is Im sin of omega t plus pi by 2. So, if we plot the voltage and current waveforms, first voltage waveform 0, V is equal to Vm sin of omega t. This is the peak value Vm. This is the amplitude here minus Vm. This is the voltage waveform V is equal to Vm sin of omega t. The current waveform is going to lead this voltage waveform by 90 degrees. It means that at this particular instant, the voltage waveform is having zero value. At this instant, the current will be having a peak value. Or we can say that the current waveform will reach its zero as well as peak value 90 degrees before the voltage waveform attains its zero as well as peak value. For example, here it can be seen that when the voltage waveform is attaining its zero value, here the current waveform will have its peak value. So, I can write Im over here. At this point, that is pi by 2, the voltage waveform is reaching its peak value. The voltage is reaching its peak value, but the current has already attained its peak value over here. The voltage is attaining its zero value over here. The current waveform will attain its zero value before 90 degrees, means over here. So, the waveform can be plotted as this is how the current waveform is plotted. The voltage waveform is zero over here. At that instant, the current waveform will be maximum. Here at this instant, the voltage is attaining its peak value. But the current at this instant is equal to 0. Here the voltage is attaining its 0 value, but the current has already attained its 0 value before 90 degrees. So, we can say that for a capacitor, the current leads the voltage by an angle of pi by 2. These are the voltage and current waveforms with respect to omega t. If we are plotting the phasor diagram, if the phasor diagram is plotted, if the voltage waveform is shown along the x-axis, this is the voltage waveform which is shown along the x-axis, the current waveform will be shown leading it by 90 degrees. The current waveform will be shown leading it by 90 degrees. So, this is the phasor diagram for a pure capacitor. Next, we will see the instantaneous value of power for a pure capacitor. The instantaneous value of the power is nothing but given by the product of the instantaneous values of voltage and current in a capacitor. Voltage is nothing but Vm sin omega t. The current is given by Im sin of omega t plus pi by 2. So this can be written as Vm sin of omega t. The current is written as Im sin of omega t plus pi by 2 is nothing but sin of pi by 2 plus omega t is nothing but cos of omega t. So this can be written as Vm Im into sin omega t cos omega t. Again, we are going to divide and multiply the term by 2. So this becomes Vm Im by 2. This is 2 sin omega t cos omega t, which is nothing but sin of 2 omega t. Therefore, the instantaneous value of the power is given by Vm Im by 2 into sin of 2 omega t. We can plot this waveform like we did for an inductor and prove that the average value of the power for a pure capacitor is 0. We will find its average value. The average value is found over a half cycle because it is a symmetrical sinusoidal waveform. Therefore, P average is equal to 1 upon pi, the integral from 0 to pi of Vm Im by 2 into sine of 2 omega t. So this becomes Vm Im by 2 pi sine of 2 omega t. The integral of sine of 2 omega t is nothing but cos. Integral of sine omega t is minus cos of 2 omega t divided by 2. So this becomes P average becomes Vm. So P average becomes Vm Im by 2 pi multiplied by 2. So it is 4 pi into cos of 2 omega t. So it is minus Vm Im by 4 pi into cos of 2 omega t. The limits are given from 0 to pi. The limits of integration are from 0 to pi. So this becomes minus Vm Im by 4 times pi into cos of, in place of omega t we put the limits, pi minus 0. So this is cos of 2 pi minus cos of 0. Cos 2 pi is 1, cos 0 is also 1. So this becomes minus Vm Im by 4 pi into 1 minus 1. So that is equal to 0. So again, the average value of the power consumed by a pure capacitor is equal to 0. So we conclude that for a pure capacitor, the current leads the voltage by 90 degrees and the average value of the power consumed by a pure capacitor is 0. So today we found that when AC circuits are connected across pure resistor, inductor or capacitor, for a resistor, the voltage and current are in phase. For an inductor, voltage leads the current by 90 degrees, and for a capacitor, the current leads the voltage by 90 degrees. The instantaneous value of the power consumed by a pure resistor is given by the product of the instantaneous values of the voltage and current, and we found it to be equal to the product of the RMS values of the voltage and current. But for a pure inductor and for a pure capacitor, the total or the average power that is consumed is 0. We conclude with this. Thank you.